mathematical model for PTC system. These equations you are already gone through. So the first one is electrical equation. RALA and this motor. EA is the applied voltage. When the voltage is applied, IA current will flow and this motor will rotate. So while rotating that motor, it is rotating in a magnetic field. So a current carrying conductor, again a conductor is rotating in a magnetic field. There is a EMF induced. That EMF is called EB. The direction of EB is opposite induced or that voltage EA. So the equation is like this. From there you can find out IA is equal to EA minus EB divided by RA. This LA dynamics you can take it as zero. And this rotor having a JM and BM for motor. So this is rotating, theta M is motor side, and this torque equation is given in 4. And this is again converted to Laplace domain as it is, and this torque is equal to KT multiplied by IA, and you can derive the block diagram as EA is applied and here EB is coming minus EB. Here 1 by RA will give you IA. And that IA is multiplied by KT will give you torque. And this torque is acting on this will give you theta of S. So torque is here 1 by JM S plus BM. This JM S square plus BM I am rewriting as it is. So you will get omega M here. Integrating you will get theta of M. And this omega M multiplied by KB will give you EB. EB equal to KB multiplied by omega M. So clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So you can get this model as it is. So is it a open loop system or a closed loop system? Sambhav Jain.
Yes, sir.
Is it an open loop system or closed loop system?
Sir, open loop system.
Yeah, it is an open loop system. So theta M upon EAF is equal to this forward path again. So it can solve it using Mason's gain formula. So the signal flow graph is like this. EA is applied voltage and KT by RA here, 1 by JMS BM and 1 by S, and this is minus KB. So according to Mason gain formula, transfer function is equal to 1 by L delta upon sigma K PK delta K. So here only one forward path. So it can rewrite as P1 delta 1 upon delta. So P1 is forward path gain. So all the gain coming in the forward path is P1. And delta 1 is, that is any loop is not touching in the forward path. But all the points are touching, so delta 1 is 1.
Sir, and why is it open loop?
Yeah. So open, so what do you mean by closed loop system?
there will be a EB that will be
there will closed. Be a feedback. That feedback for a closed loop control system is defined as we are measuring. We are measuring something to achieve a desired output. So for a desired output, we are measuring something. So we have to give a input such that our desired output should meet. So here theta is the output. So we are not at all measuring anything from this part, and we are not comparing with anything. This loop is actually natural to the motor. So all the motor having this KB will be there, because when a motor you are supplying a current, it will rotate. So it is rotating in a magnetic field. So a conductor rotating in a magnetic field, an EMF is produced in that conductor. So that conductor is acting as a generator while rotating it as motor. So that is called back EMF, because we are applying a voltage EA this direction. So the flux direction also will be same. So according to motor principle, this that Fleming's rule. So the applied voltage and the flux direction is like this. Flux direction and applied voltage. So the rotation will be in the third axis. So for a generator, this rotation is fixed actually, and the flux direction also fixed. So it should generate a current or a voltage in such a way that it should be like this. So that the EMF is called back EMF. So it is a natural phenomenon. We are not measuring anything from output and supplying back. It's a natural feedback. So that is called, it is an open loop system because it is a natural. If you are measuring something from omega here, omega you are measuring using a Tycho generator, and you are feedbacking it here, it is called a feedback system. But here you are not measuring anything inside the motor and you are not feedbacking. That is called, it is an open loop system. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So according to Mason-Gain formula, this delta equal to 1 minus individual loop gains. So here only one loop is there. So 1 minus that loop gain. This loop gain. So that loop gain is like this. So theta of S by EFS is written as this, where J is equal to JM and B is equal to BM plus KT KV by R. So the J is JM and B is additional factor is adding here. So this is how you can solve using Mason-Gain formula. You can use by Bloch-Dirac reduction, that also fine. And then you are connecting to a external load. This motor now it is having JM and BM. That is connected through a gear to JL and BL. So this torque production is here only. That motor has to produce the torque. And if you are adding something load here, that also provided from the motor only. So that is through a gear. So theta M upon NM by NL will give you theta L. And the torque equation is JL square plus BLS into theta L. So this multiplied by this one, this is not 1 by JL square plus BLS, this slope. And the theta L is coming here. That multiplied by that will give you TL. So TL you have to convert that back to motor side. that is why this nm by nl equation is there. So this nm by nl here and this nm by nl here. So the nm by nl the whole square multiplied by this one. The theta m is coming here and ea is there. Again, this having two loops. This is forward path. And here is theta m upon ea you have to find out. So only one forward path. So according to Mason gain formula, p1 delta 1 divided by delta. But it having two loops. This one first loop, this is second loop. So only one forward path. So p1 you can find out like this. And p11 is this loop again. And p12 is this loop again. So p11 is this loop again. P12 is the second loop again. And the transfer function is p1 delta 1 upon delta. So delta is equal to 1 minus p11 plus p12. Individual loop again. So solving this one, you will get theta m upon ea of s as it is. Where this equation you can combine j, this two combine j square plus b, j equivalent, b equivalent. Yes, like that you can do, and you will get the equation as in the given. So today's lab is you have to design a compensator for electromagnetic engine gimbal control, and you have to perform the system performance using linear system performance. So linear system analysis you have to use. The first point is you have to do a proportional plus rate feedback control. So proportional plus rate feedback control is you having a proportional gain, and this omega m you have to measure it, and that sensor having some sensor gains, and that you have to feedback. So the proportional controller plus this omega you are measuring and feedbacking, this is called proportional plus rate feedback. And second one is proportional plus rate plus integral controller. So second one is you have to add a integrator. Integrator is k into 1 by s. So these two are adding. This is called kp k by s. Is called P plus I plus. So this is called PI rate. Omega you are measuring and feedbacking. This is called PI plus rate feedback. That is the second one. Third one is PID. So that case, you have to remove the rate. So you have to remove the rate feedback. You are not at all using any TACO generator. You are only using KP, K into 1.
Sir, what is TACO generator?
TACO generator is speed measuring device. It is actually a generator. So generator equation is, if you are having a generator, that is having a magnetic field. So that EMF generator is equal to 5ZPN by 6EA. So this is permanent magnetic, is phi is constant, Z is number of parallel paths that will be constant, P is number of poles. So Z is number of conductor, A is number of parallel paths, and EG is directly proportional to N. N is the speed of the motor. So using a simple DC small generator, suppose some 10 volt generator. So if you are using that one, So if you are using that one, you can directly measure that voltage is directly proportional to n. So you will directly get the speed. This is called tap on generator. So you have to connect on taco in the shaft. So directly you will get speed of the shaft. So if you are using a rotary encoder for position measurement, so you will directly get the theta value. If you are using that a taco generator, then you will get directly the speed. So that is called taco feedback. So here you have to use P plus I plus D, and D is KD into S. So this third one is improper transfer function. That a proper transfer function is denominator polynomial should be equal to or greater than numerator polynomial. That is a proper transfer function. If you are entering like this in MATLAB, it will create an error. So avoiding that error, you will place a pole very far away. If your system poles are like this here, in between this, you will place a far away pole. So you will place some S plus 300 or something, because it is around 27 or some 28, it is coming. So 10 times greater than one pole you will place. So it is like this only, it is implementing. So it is called improper transfer function. For making it proper, you will place a far away pole. So this one, this is having one addition. It is K2 only, not K. This is the block diagram. So this one is theta, this equation, that is this one, and we are measuring this omega. This is called taco generator feedback, and this K2 is the controller gain for rate feedback, and this is the proportional gain constant K1. So this is called rate feedback, and this is called position feedback. So this Kp is the, you are measuring theta from here, and this theta corresponding to here desired value. So you can do it in two ways. You can give this theta directly here as a voltage corresponding to our desired value. So here you will get theta, and that theta and this theta is measured using the sensor gains, and that gain you can give it here. It is called forward path Kp. Or else you can use voltage as input, and this theta you measure, and the feedback path you use the Kp value. Here you are using this Kp in the forward path, and the theta reference you are giving here. Theta reference you are giving as input. So input is your theta reference. Not the voltage reference you are giving. You are giving only the theta reference. That is, it is mentioned in theta C. So if you are giving it as a voltage reference, the Kp will be in the feedback path. Clear? So this J value as told earlier, Jm plus n square into JL, B is having Bm plus KTKB by RA plus n square BL. This capital K is KT by RA, these values, these entire values, the KT, KB, JM, JL, this NM by NL can give us N 1 by 398. BM, BL, RA, KP, KTG. These values you have to enter as a parameter file. A script file, you open it and you can name it as some parameter.m. And you have to design the controller gains K1 and K2. This is you have to design. So if you are solving that equation, the closed loop system from this equation, this equation for a closed loop system, we are comparing this with standard second order system equation, then you can get K1 as it is and the K2 as it is. This is sums are taken last week. And you have to design a controller for specification. So here the specification given are minus 3 dB bandwidth is 5 hertz and the theta value is 0.6. These two are the specification given to you. So you have to design a controller such that the minus 3 dB bandwidth is 5 hertz and the damping factor is 0.6. So if you are studied in root locus, this omega n is coming as this concentric circles and theta values are coming like this, theta 1, theta 2. So these are the specifications. So you can design using this root locus techniques or Bode techniques or this equating these two things. Anything you can do. And these are the specifications. One is given as time domain specification. One is given in frequency domain specification. This relation you can get it using omega v is equal to omega n upon this equation. So omega b is given as 5 hertz. You have to convert this to radian. And theta value is given. So you can find out omega n. So omega n find out, you substitute here. Then you will get k1 and k2 directly. Because only missing term is omega n here. So you can get the omega n value. Omega n is 5 hertz, corresponding you have to convert it to radian. And then comes your procedure. So first procedure is you enter those things and find out these three values. Omega n, k1 and k2. So if you are entering those in parameter and running the parameter, you will get k1, k2 and omega n. And you have to enter it here. Second one is draw the simulink model. So you have to patch up the simulink model. For a closed loop system and find out the performances using simulink LTAVR. So simulink LTAVR last week you have seen. So input you have to mark it as input perturbation and output you have to measure it and then go to control this analysis, control design, linear analysis. And there you have it to do for these five performances. So in these five performances, two are in frequency domain and these three are in time domain. So it is a linear system and these three are in time domain. So you have to plot step response to find out these three values. So rise time is, so if we are having a step response like this, so 10% to 90% value time is rise time. And peak overshoot is, this one is called peak overshoot. And settle time is the 2% band where it is coming. It's called 2% settling time. These three values you will get it using step response analysis of LTA viewer. And the border response you are taking, you will get M peak and -3 dB band. So -3 dB is from 0, so -3 point. The response is like this. You note down this value. This is called -3 dB bandwidth. And M peak is this, here on peak will occur. This is called M peak. So you have to do the Bode response. So what is the input for Bode?
Sinusoidal wave.
Yeah, sinusoidal wave, that frequency is changing from very low value to very high value. Then you will get the response that is called the sinusoidal response. And you will get these two things from the Bode response and these three things from the step response. And that is for first part. Proportional plus rate feedback. Then second part is.
Sir, you can are, you repeat the last 2 minutes? I got disconnected.
Hello.
Sir, I was disconnected. So can you repeat the last 2 minutes?
These three are for step response. These two performances you will get it from step response. These two you will get it from Bode response. Bode response is actually a sinusoidal response. So you have to patch up the simulating block for this block diagram. So this Kp, Ki, K1, Kp, K2, KTG are gains. And these two are summer blocks. This is the transfer function and this one is the integrator. So you have to patch up this simulating block diagram and do the LTA viewer, simulating LTA viewer. Then from the step response you will get these three values and in frequency response you will get these two values and fill the first column. And second one is P plus I plus rate feedback. You have to add an integrator there. So first one block diagram will be like this. So you have to patch up the simulating block diagram. First of all, you have to enter all the parameter that are given in your sheet from here to here. And this one, this omega theta, the omega v is 5 into 2 pi you have to add, because that 5 hertz is given, you have to convert that. And this omega n, all other values you have to enter, and k1, k2 you have to add. So first you enter this parameter file. 5 minutes I will give you. 5 minutes is enough now. And then patch up this block diagram. all of you mark the attendance. All of you done? So the K1 KT values are K1 KT values
19.5 K1.
0.9538 omega n omega n
27.36.
So all of you got these values?
Yes.
Sir, hello.
Hello.
Sir, here BL is equal to 58.86 you have written.
Yeah.
But in the
hello.
Hello.
Tell me.
In the PDF, sim to PDF that you have given, there ball to screw ratio that parameter is given as
1/398. Here and are 1/398.
This one.
N. Okay, sir. So N number N, you cannot enter as it is in MATLAB. So divided by time is coming means. Otherwise, NM underscore NL you have to type it. So if you are complete these things, you have to run this file and you have to open Simulink and Simulink. This is the adder block. This I am done K1. This gains I am multiplied inside. You can use separate also. Like this, you can use. Here is the input plus here minus gain block KP K1 this plus this minus here capital K upon capital J S plus B. This is the transfer function block. These are gain block. This is summer block. Again, this one is integrator. And this gain, these are our gain blocks, KTG, K2. These are our gain blocks. This transfer function block. So gain block you can find out in math toolbox. Transfer function and integrator in continuous. Summer also in math toolbox. You can find out and you have to apply on input. That input you can use. Either steps or sine wave. This is not required. And if you are having any doubt, double click on their gain, you will get the gain. Double click on the white space and enter this magnifying glass, you will get gain. And this parameter you can enter by double clicking this gain block. Inside this you can give K1, K2 like that. And if you want to rotate this one to 180 degree, so click on here. Control I or Control R two times otherwise Control I and this is plus minus here also plus minus this integrator block and this transfer function is find out in continuous block this continuous block. Transfer function and this one is integrate. And the order and the gains you can find out in math operations. This add you can use otherwise here subtract is there and the summer is there. These three are equal only. And this your space option in sinks your space
sir
what
and sir what is that by I means in output there that by
this
term is
your space
what sir
this your space sinks your space
okay sir
your space here searching that one two is enough first one is your space which we showing. So in that you have to make variable name y and save format array. And this clock you can find out in sources. Sources you will get clock, the sine wave step, anything you can get it in sources.
Hello sir.
Yeah.
Sir, in that why you have written a variable?
Yeah, I am. Yeah, y as variable.
Before that one black color column, what is that?
Yeah, that is not required.
Okay.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, with the clock, it's that T is also that workspace.
Yeah, that also workspace. The variable name is T only.
Okay.
You can drag this, right click and drag it. This will Y1 you can change to T. These gains you can add separately.
Sir, what this T will do?
T is actually, it is a clock now.
Yeah.
It is connected to a clock, then you will get time.
Okay.
So if you are in run this one and plot the T comma Y means,
okay,
you will get the response in the workspace. If you want to save this Y and T, it will be saved in dot mat. So if you want to use some other purpose for this Y and T, you can save it as dot mat file. So if you are completed up to this, right click on this line, linear analysis point, input perturbation. Right click on the first line, linear analysis point, input perturbation. And here, that is going to Y after the integrator. Right click on this line. Linear analysis point, output measurement. So anybody having any doubts on this parameter K1, K2 and omega n?
Sir, in the last line you have written KI and KD. Means how are you getting that?
Yeah, these all are second and third step only. I have entered everything here. That time you can enter. Otherwise you can connect, insert in that gain block itself. First experiment that line number 13, this is not required. This is not required for this one. Here you are using proportional plus rate feedback only. So if you are using integrator, that integrator gain is KI. So if you are using PAD, that KD is, that PAD is KD gain. That you can directly insert in that gain block.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, from where you get that linear output in that step input data summation box line?
This line you right click.
Yeah.
Linear analysis point.
Okay. Input perturbation.
Input perturbation and click on that output line, output measurement.
Okay, sir.
So you are using then 2019 version, then go to analysis on the top of Simulink. Here you will get some analysis block. In that analysis you click it, down you will get control design, there linear analysis. If you are using 2019 B version, or 2019 some A version, you go to apps. So linearization manager, you can get these things. So if we are using older version, if you are using older versions, so here you will get on analysis tab. In that analysis tab, you have to choose these things. Before that, you have to enter the configuration parameter. So how to enter configuration parameter? This model configuration parameter, solver, you have to choose fixed step, and ODE for fixed step size is 0.001. So you will get a gear here in your version. Click on that model configuration parameter. Otherwise, you in your keyboard Control plus E, you will get this model configuration parameter. There you have to use solver type fixed step, solver ODE for fixed step size is 0.001. Then linearization. So for your version, go to analysis, control design, linear analysis. It will pop up like this. Same as it is. You click on the step, you will get the step response. And right click on the step response characteristics, you will get peak response, settling time, rise time, and steady state. So the characteristic three things you are required.
Sir, can you repeat again that output part?
Yeah, this up to this you are done now. Up to this.
Yes, sir.
Up to this you are done. You press Control E.
Control E.
So it will pop up configuration parameter.
Yeah, this I wrote it down.
Yeah, here you have to choose solver type.
Rangi Kutta. Yeah, I done it.
Solver ODE for fixed step time is 0.001. Done.
Yes, sir.
Then you are here on tab, analysis tab is there, analysis.
Yeah, analysis tab.
Yeah, analysis tab, you click it, control design.
Control design, then?
It linear analysis.
Linear analysis.
We are using 2019 version, linearization, model linearizer. So it will pop up this window.
Yes, sir.
Two windows are same. So you click on step, you will get step response. Between this point and this, this is taken as input and this is taken as output. from this input perturbation point, it will supply a unit step, and here you will get the output response, and the output is floating here. So whatever input you are giving, you are going to linear analysis, it will linearize between this input perturbation and output measurement. So you are using sine wave also, you will get step response only. It will supply step input here and here and plot it. And right click on the white space here, characteristics, you will get peak response, settling time, rise time, these values. Right click on this settling time, you just go there, you will get values.
Sir, it is showing some error.
What error it is showing?
Means I think that J in the transfer function you define a J dot S.
Yeah, but firstly I told you, you have to run the parameter file. This parameter file you are running, it is saving in the workspace. And second thing is, all the things will be in the same folder. I am using this parameter file here and model file here. So everything is in same folder. If you are running this parameter file, it will save in the workspace. That same workspace is using for the simulating model also. So if you are doing it in some other workspace and some other folder, error will come.
Okay, sir.
So right click here, rise time, you will get rise time. Rise time for MATLAB, it is 10% to 90%. Some of the textbooks, if you are using normal science, it is also given 10% to 90%. Some of the textbooks, it is written 0 to 100%. So in MATLAB, it is taken 10% to 90%. So the last three parts, it is completed. That is peak overshoot, rise time, settling time. So these three things you will get it from step response. Then you click on order response.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, in the transfer function, how you write that J dot S plus B in the denominator part?
J dot S plus B, that is
A. Yeah, means I.
Function, you just enter J space B.
J
numerator space is
okay.
A.
Yeah.
Denominator is J space B.
Yeah, okay, sir.
So last time you are absent. Last week?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, transfer function entering, it is. So if you are having a transfer function like this, so if you are adding 1, 2, 3, 4 denominator, it will be. What should it? 1 space, 2 space, 3 space, 4. What should be the denominator?
Yeah, JSS means JS cube power 4, then S cube, then S square, and
S raised to 3 plus 2S square plus 3S plus 4. So numerator you are adding 1 space, 0 space, 5. What do you get? S square plus 5.
S square plus 5, yeah. Then, sir, from that step response graph means what I have to miss take?
What?
Means from that step response graph.
Yeah. Step response graph, you will get what are the parameters?
Peak time and what is
peak time you will get?
Sir, if the input is step, then also we'll get the same graph.
What?
If the input was step,
input you are giving step and output you are measuring, you will get same. Because it is a linear system. linear analysis and linearization it is doing also, it will be same. But you have to measure from that. It is just a plot only. Plot t, y means you will get. Here you are plotting. Plot t, y. You will get same plot. T is undefined. It is out only, it is saving, I think.
Sir, can you repeat again that step in response graph?
Yeah, here your input is this sine wave, that is why I am getting like this. If I am changing that to step, you will get same step response. Step time is 0, output final rate is 1. Running. Yeah, the same graph only you will get it there also. If I am reducing this time to 0.5 seconds, so 0.6 seconds, I am getting the exact. Like this plot only you will get it. So, what you have to do is, right click on this line, linear analysis point, input perturbation point. Here it is output measurement. Then then go to linearization, linear analysis, you will get step plot like this.
Sir, how you get that line means for data settling time and latch time?
You right click it, characteristics, these three you take it. Okay, you will get all the things. This is the right time.
Sir, to get the minus 3 dB from the phase plot, do we have to do it manually or?
Manually you have to do. Click on here, minus 3 and measure the value.
Okay, sir.
And after this, you are going to that Bode plot.
Yeah, Bode is nothing. Here, you clicking Bode means you will get Bode.
Okay.
Now you are done.
Mine is showing some error.
Yes, sir. I'll put this on computer.
And Bode response also same characteristics, peak response, you will directly get minus 3 dB bandwidth. You have to click on this line and move to minus 3 and note the frequency value and then fill the column. Fill the column. First column you have to fill. And the corresponding comments and performance comparison you have to write. So if you are completed first thing, then we can move to second.
Sir, how you select that minus three decibel in that Bode plot?
Yeah, minus three, you take the minus 3 point.
How?
Click on this line.
Okay.
Drag it then minus 3.
Yes,
Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Somebody else is.
Yes, sir. My system is showing some error.
What error?
So it is like a linearization I'm trying to do, but it is not doing.
Can you share your screen?
Okay.
Hello. क्या हो रहा है?
The phone you have to show the your block diagram, simulating block diagram.
Okay, sir.
Sir,
yeah,
after subtracting that minus 3 decibel, what again I have to do?
That much only. That is the first test. When you have to, then you have to do the comments about these things. That is first test. Second one is you have to do a PI controller. Where is your block diagram? Hello.
Yes, sir. But the sharing is stopping even when I'm trying. Sir, can you see that?
No. Done that one. We can do second one. Second one is here. You have to add one
sir,
more.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, we have to do that a step input instead of SAR input again.
No.
That.
Whatever input you are giving, it will take it as a step only, four-step response in linear analysis. Linear analysis, this point, whatever input you are giving, it will, if you are plotting step response, here it will supply step and it will cut this line. This line it will cut and it will supply a step here. It will measure this from here. If you are giving sine wave also giving, it will get, you will get step response only. Here you see like this. Border response means it will supply sine wave and it will take it and it will plot the border response. So whichever input here, it won't mind. So next one is PI plus rate feedback. So the rate feedback is there. Rate feedback is there. As this one, this KP and KA, now you have to add one more gain. So earlier KP and K1 is multiplied. Now you have to say one more KP you have to add and the KA you have to segregate. And in parallel with this proportional gain, you have to add a KI gain and an integrator and add. So, PI plus rate feedback is this error signal, it is coming here. That error signal only going to K1 path, and another one is Ki into 1 by S. You are adding both two, and here the rate feedback is there. So this is the block diagram simulating pattern for proportional plus this Ki. Other things are same. You have to add one Ki here and 1 by S. This Ki gain is given here. So you have to add a integral controller. That transfer function of the integral controller is Ki by S in parallel with the proportional controller gain K1. So proportional controller gain K1, you have to add parallel block. So K1, you have to add one parallel block, Ki into 1 by S, and you have to add it up. And this gain Ki is K1 by 10. This Ki value is K1 by 10. And they repeat the measurement as in the second. So you have to do same thing, but you have to add this one. That is for second exercise. That is this one. Input perturbation you have to add, output measurement you have to add, linear analysis. So you are having now this plus and minus block. So double click on that, and first you add one more plus, it will become 2 plus and 1 minus, and this one you select it, and this one should be coming here only. This minus is here. Again, you have to add one more here, like this only. So, you can copy your earlier folder, and you have to segregate this K1 and KP. Then you can do. Like the same thing that you are done, you have to segregate this proportional gain and KP. Earlier you are done KP and K multiplied, so you have to segregate these two, and from here you have to add integral gain and integrator. This is available in math toolbox. This is in continuous block, and you have to make this three input summer. So making this two input to three input, first point you have to add one more plus, okay, and you can select it. Other things are same. Repeat the experiment and find out the values.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Sir, we have to define that ki again in that MATLAB code.
Otherwise, you can just take ka 1 by 10.
Okay, means just write where?
Yeah, that's the gain block now.
Yeah.
Yeah, here I have defined ka is equal to ka 1 by 10. Okay. Otherwise, in this, here also, that gain. Gain. You select that gain. Here you can mention K1 by 10.
Okay.
K1 by 10. Both are equal only.
Sir, in my, the solver is coming auto or OD 854321.
This fixed step you have to use type.
Yes.
Type is fixed step, solver is ODE4, and the solver details fixed step size is 0.001.
Okay.
Sir,
yeah.
Sir, what is that? Solver details for this one.
Everything is same. Control A. Fixed step.
0.01. Okay, sir.
44.001.
After this, sir?
After the same. That input perturbation, output measurement. This line, right click. This line, you right click. Linear analysis point, input perturbation. This line, you right click. Linear analysis point, output measurement. Then go to analysis. Control design, linear analysis. Then step, you will get step response. Mode, you will get mode response. Then find out parameter values, characteristics. Those responses.
Sir.
Yeah.
at minus 3 decibel means at there means what value you have to find?
Yeah, at minus 3
means there means what things we have to observe?
This minus 3 dB bandwidth. So minus 3 dB bandwidth is,
yeah,
we are having a body plot like this. This is 0 dB. 0 dB means input and output gain are equal.
Yeah.
And if this is the body plot, minus 3 dB point you have to find out. And
yes,
this is the frequency corresponding to minus 3 dB bandwidth. So this is the bandwidth of this. So that frequency you have to find out.
Okay.
So clicking this one, you will get the frequency here.
Yeah.
That is called minus 3 dB bandwidth frequency. This is in radian per second, you have to convert that to hertz.
Okay, sir.
But here it is even hertz only, I think. Hertz only. Here it is given hertz. So that you have to convert.
Sir, is there any way to means just type on minus 3 dB on the graph and then it shows the value?
Yeah, that one also you do. Other thing MATLAB is giving me. Otherwise you write a code for that. Yeah, are the 28 people are doing these things? Yeah.
Sir, peak value is the peak value in the Bode plot only, no? At which the curve starts.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. M peak is this peak. Here on peak will come. This is all the, if you are drawing a Bode plot like this. So it will come here and it is like this only. This is called peak response. So right click, you will get here. Peak again.
Okay, sir.
So for the third case,
yeah.
When we draw branch for the derivative, it should also come after KP, right?
Yeah, you just read it. Add a derivative controller. That controller value is KD into S divided by 1 plus S by 300, where KD is equal to K2 into KTG divided by KP in parallel with the PA controller. So this is the PA controller here. So in parallel with this PA controller is KD into S by 300 plus 1. So this you have to add here. And one more thing is there. And remove the rate feedback controller. So you have to remove the rate feedback controller. So PID, the D is actually doing rate feedback. I think Saris explained last class.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. This is actually doing the rate feedback only. So D you are inserting, that time you have to remove the rate feedback section. So rate feedback section you have to remove it, and then this rate feedback, now it is cut. In that type you are adding a D here in parallel with the controller, and here it is plus only, earlier it is negative only. Rate feedback is output to here it is connected, so that is negative. Negative feedback only. Here KD into S divided by S by 1 plus 300, S by 300 plus 1 you have to add, and it is in addition only. P plus I plus D only. Rate feedback is like this only, it is given. Rate feedback is G upon E. This is H means, minus means G upon 1 plus DH is coming. So the here plus coming, here minus you have to put. If you are using like this feed forward means, you have to put all these plus, plus, plus. That is the only difference. So this PID will be like this only. Third case. All the things are remain same. This rate feedback, here this rate is here, from here to here rate is removed, and you are adding a derivative gain. KD is equal to, this value of KD is also given, KD equal to K2 into KTG divided by KP, K2 into KTG divided by KP into S divided by S by 300 plus 1. So the numerator is 10, denominator is 1 by 300, 1. So this you have to set up, and input perturbation, output measurement, configuration parameter, everything you have to enter. Same thing you have to do. Then you have to fill this code also. Then the sixth point is your, give your comments. So these comments you have to write it and submit the reports. Reports is from 1 to 6 only. This 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And submit your code, and the XLS file or .mdl file. In your reports, you have to add these figures and other things. So if you want this figure, want to save this prefigure, then you can save it. All of you completed?
Yes, sir.
Those who are completed, they have to write the report and submit by next week. So this performance table and your comments, these comments contain marks. So you do your comments and you can submit to that mail ID is given. Otherwise in Moodle also you can do.
Hello sir.
Yeah.
In the coming Monday also our lab only, no? Or the first batch lab?
First batch lab only. You are having only, this lab is only once in a week, ma'am.
Not sure, we used to have on Monday, that's why I have confusion.
Yeah, that is our role. If we, something like this is coming, some whole days are coming, it will be shifted to next lab. So Monday, Friday is your lab short means either batch. Some other batch having Monday, some whole day or something is there. Then your lab will be shifted one more week. Otherwise, you are having 2 weeks ahead of them. That is not good. So alternatively, you will shift these things if 4 days are coming. So those who are completed, they can leave.
Sir.
Yeah.
So how you save that image in MATLAB file?
This image.
Yeah.
Image you can save. You go to this step plot here. On the top step plot will be coming now. And here you have to use print to figure. So it will pop up another window. This window you can save it whichever way you want. File, save as either MATLAB figure or EPS or PNG, JPEG, PDF, anything. And you can insert legends, X label, Y label, all other things here. So you got it now? So if you want to change the scale X axis, then also you can do it here.
Sir,
yeah,
sir, for the last part, I am getting two graph for that border plot.
Two graph.
Yeah, miss. It's combination of.
Yeah, that you are connected this output measurement here only.
Okay, then.
Output measurement here only. It will get only one graph.
Okay.
Sir, I can't do the linearization part.
Why?
2014 model.
Yeah,
I have the 2014 model.
You install that thing, control system toolbox, you install it, you can do it.
I have every toolbox is installed, but sir, it is showing some error.
Your input perturbation and output measurement not be there. You will input and input port and output port might be. That perturbation and output measurement might not be there. You right click on that one, linear analysis input point and output point, I think. In 2014,
okay.
I think so. And your control design is not coming under analysis. You have to search it tools. Control design like that only. I remember like that only. I don't know. You search for tools, control design. After 2015 only they are going to analysis. Now it is going to apps. It also there, I think. If your control system toolbox is there, it will be there. 2007 onwards, it is there. Control system design. That time not this much of advanced.
Sir, I am getting some not that graph.
A input point, output point might be there.
Sir, I did that and I am getting some other graph.
Can you show your screen?
Sir, completed now.
Yeah.